Hi. Note the new appearance. I open with this particular shot of, trying not to be too revealing with my probably slightly overweight body, but that much aside, I open with this shot for a reason. Let's just try and get a little bit closer with my hand to that scar. Can you see it? I'm afraid I'm not a hairy chest kind of guy, ladies, and please, this is really not going to make anything of an impression on the media for the bloody Chippendales or whatever, but just look at that scar, will you, okay? It's underneath it, there are still clips holding my ribcage together. I'm quite proud of my clips, actually. I appear quite often on a site called British Hearties. But that's the scar from seabag surgery. Coronary artery bypass graft surgery. Right, well, let's put the scar away, because I don't want to frighten the horses in public. And just give you a second or two to get used to the new appearance. Yeah. And if anyone says I look like Private Pyle, they're probably about right. Political. Yeah, it is. And this is me doing my bit for the Labour Party. I have to tell you, I'm not up to canvassing. I don't think I have the confidence to do it. So I'm doing my canvassing on here. But why did I open showing you that scar? Because I've just read that on the Andrew Marr show today, the BBC, of course, mainstream media, Theresa May said there are complex reasons why people go to food banks. Not just people, because Andrew Marr was mentioning nurses going to feed food banks. Note, nursing, medical, scar. Yep. The most amazing surgeons in our NHS, note I say our NHS, performed that surgery on me. They were incredible. I say this again and again and again, and I will never stop saying it. Our NHS saved my life. NHS in Peterborough, where the heart attack started, and the NHS in Papworth, where I got a stent put in, and I subsequently had coronary artery graft, bypass graft surgery. Let me just put in another one as well, just for all of you racist UKippers and most likely racist Tories out there, for scum like you, yeah? The person who did that surgery, who put these clips in here in the end, was a fantastic Muslim guy. I'm delighted. I'm actually delighted that inside me, I have a piece of his craft, a piece of his work. He kept me going. I'm going still because of him and his team. That's what the NHS does. Yeah. It saves lives. One day, if it's still around, it might save your life. Just think about it. One day, it might save your life. So, May says, in relation to nurses, back to the NHS again, using food banks, people who cared for me after this, looked after me, put all the drips in my neck, in my arms, put an intra-aortic pump into me by using a femoral artery, talked to me when I didn't know what was going on. All those nurses, yeah? Now, and probably even then, they're using food banks to stay alive. As you know, my son is training as a nurse, so I've got a pretty good idea about it. He's in the second year. I love him to bits, and I cannot wait for him to graduate. Don't think, of course, that nurses just suddenly stop what they're doing and go home. Of course they don't. The NHS runs on their goodwill. If you're up to your elbows in somebody's chest and you're a surgeon, you can't really just kind of leave them alone and go, well, that's right, I'm clocking off now. Bye. Yep. You stay till the end. Nurses stay till the end. How can it be that these people who save and sustain lives and who care for us at our weakest, our most dependent, our most frightened, these professionals who train, like my son, for 3 years to degree level, and then often go on, of course, to do more training, how can it be that Theresa May's organised a society where they need to use food banks, but billionaires don't bat an eyelid, do they? They probably have the caviar and the T-bones choppered in onto their nicely manicured lawn. They've probably got Bollinger on tap, and apparently, I am told in that interview with May, that she made every effort to hide the gold watch on her wrist when she was asked about people going to food banks. People, I ask you, vote Labour. If you vote for May, I'm finished. Many more like me are going to be finished. Many of those of us who are sick and disabled, have heart conditions, long-term conditions, mental illness in particular, we're finished. Voting for her in a few years is signing our death warrants. We won't be here. One thing for certain, though, the billionaires will be even richer. There'll be even more of them. And, of course, as for you and your kids, well, think about the future. And here is a little one I came up with on the future. This, I imagine, is the future under the Tories. Once again, if you want a vision of the future, imagine a boot stamping on a human face forever. Let's stop this. Vote Labour.